So we start a new segment on the program this week, a nightly effort to point out hypocrisy, double talk, stuff that just is downright ridiculous. We call it the Ridiculist. So who's on the list tonight? Well, it's the TV network PBS for their claims about why they edited Tina Fey. Now, Tina Fey received the prestigious Mark Twain Prize for American Humor at the Kennedy Center last week. In her acceptance speech, she thanked many people, including Sarah Palin, who Fey obviously imitated a lot during the 2008 presidential campaign. But what viewers of PBS saw on TV was very different from what people at the awards ceremony actually saw. So here's what Tina Fey had to say about Palin and conservative women during the awards ceremony.
I would be a liar and an idiot if I didn't thank Sarah Palin for helping get me here tonight. My partial resemblance and her crazy voice are the two luckiest things that have ever happened to me. And, you know, politics aside, the success of Sarah Palin and women like her is good for all women. Except, of course, those who will end up, you know, like paying for their own rape kit and stuff. But for everybody else, it's a win-win. Unless you're a gay woman who wants to marry your partner of 20 years, whatever. But for most women, the success of conservative women is good for all of us. Unless you believe in evolution. You know what? Actually, I take it back. The whole thing's a disaster. All kidding aside, I'm so proud to represent American humor.
All right, on Sunday night, PBS viewers watching the pre-taped event didn't hear any of that. This is what viewers heard instead.
I would be a liar and an idiot if I didn't thank Sarah Palin for helping get me here tonight. My partial resemblance and her crazy voice are the two luckiest things that have ever happened to me. All kidding aside, I'm so proud to represent American humor.
All right, producers cut out approximately 33 seconds of Fey's jokes about Palin and conservative women. They insist, however, politics or fear of criticism had nothing to do with it. One of the executive producers of the program told the Washington Post that they trimmed parts of Fey's acceptance speech not because of content, but due to time. The ceremony ran 19 minutes too long, and he said a lot of it was trimmed. That may be so, but it's hard to believe they would choose to trim from one of the main winner's speeches, especially considering they just happened to cut the controversial stuff out. It's fine if they wanted to avoid controversy, I understand that, but they should just admit it. Pretending it had nothing to do with politics, that just sounds ridiculous. And that earns them a spot on tonight's Ridiculist.